And you know what does it mean by grace? Grace are the things that we don't deserve. And the grace only applied to human beings. At atin lang yun, binigay ng Diyos. Ang kanyang grace is, ang kanyang, ha? Biyaya. Okay? In grace. So, it applied only to His important creation, and that is human. So today, I'm going to share with you, okay, let us pray first. Let us pray. Let us bow down our head and let us pray. Panginoong Diyos, napakabuti mo sa aming buhay, O God. Tunay nga, O Diyos, ang iyong biyaya ay parang ulan na patuloy na pumapatak sa amin, O God. Bagaman kami, Panginoon, ay hindi tapat sa iyo, O Diyos, bagaman kami, Panginoon, ay hindi sumusunod sa iyo, lumalayo sa iyo, Lord, subalit ang iyong biyaya at ang iyong pag-ibig sa amin ay walang katapusan, O Diyos. Lord, marami pong salamat. Wala po kaming words na i-describe kung sino ka sa aming buhay, O Lord. At kami po ay nagpapasalamat, O Lord. At Lord, tulungan mo kami, O Diyos, na maunawaan kang mabuti sa aming buhay, O Diyos. At Lord, help us, Lord, also to worship you, O God. The worship that's coming from our heart, O God. Not only the sounds that coming from our mouth, but the worship that's coming from our heart, O God. And Lord, we can only do that by your help, O God. At ganun din, Panginoon, Lord, as we study this word, Lord, I pray that it will sink into our heart, O God, and we can apply this into our daily lives. And this is our prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. So the title of my message today is, can you read? Can worry add a single moment to your life? Can worry add a single moment to your life? Madalas po tayong nag-worry sa ating buhay. But dito po sa test, dito na sa'yo, the title, I took the title from one of the verses, okay? And as sabi po dito, in other translation, it says that can worry add one cubit into the measure of your life? And what is the measure? What is the length of one cubit? One cubit is from the elbow to the middle finger. So that's a cubit length of, yun sinasabi. And this measure was used during the ancient time. At tayo po bilang isang tao, okay, ay hindi po tayo, we are not dreaming of adding a single moment to our life. Pag ba may birthday ka, pinagpe-pray, Lord, I pray that you would add a single moment to the life of this person. Diba? No one would ever dream of that. Pero sinasabi, Lord, I pray that you would give more years and years to the life of this person. So ito po, sabi niya, kung hindi ka nga mabibigyan ng 1 year, how much more hindi ka mabibigyan ever a single moment to your life sa pag-worry mo kung ano namang mga bagay. Rag, sorry, paki-ano naman doon? Medyo, yung heater. That's it, thank you. So, the point here is why you need to worry. It won't give a single moment to your life anyway. But the things that people worry about are looks. Meron ba? Siguro hindi tayo, we don't have a problem with our looks, no? We don't worry about that. The Lord of the Harvest doesn't worry about looks dahil we are all handsome and beautiful. But the next one would be what? Money? Biglang tumahimik. And the love for this side, do you worry about love? Wala ka pang nakikitang maliligawan? Or pag naman naligaw ka, sasagutin ba ako nito? Or kung yung mga girls naman, giligawan ba ako nito? You worry about love and mahal ba talaga niya ako? Okay, kaya huwag muna kayo mag-boyfriend, no? We're always telling you. Pag-aral mabuti. Don't worry about that. And God will give that to you. Success! Okay? Family, we worry about family, about our clothes. Okay? ano ba, namumroblema ba tayo sa mga isusuot natin? Alam mo, nakita ko na yung mga taong may problema kung anong bibihisin, ay yung mga taong napakaraming damit. Yun yung mga tao that they're always worried about what they're going to wear. But you look at their closet, there's no space anymore. Kasi it was already shown in the Facebook and this kind of dress, so I cannot wear that anymore. So you better buy a disposable. So throw it out after that. So what else are we worried about? We worried about paying bills? Okay. Paying bills or impressing other people? Di ba, medyo pag may crush ka, magpapakanda ka. Ano? Ganun, yung mga gupit natin buhok, diba? Pag galaw-galaw, no? yung mga nagpapansin, yung mga galaw ng buhok, yung mga galaw ng inek, ganun, no? So, you're impressing other people, and you're worried, really, if other people impressed with you. Health is one of our worries, and that, of course. Some people worried about little things. Some people worried about small things, but we are all worried, okay? I myself worried. Yun nga sa health and death, pag nag-o-opera kami, okay? Alam mo na, it's like worry, alam mo, pag nakikita mo yung mga internal organ nila, parang meron ako na. Alam mo, lahat ng mga nakikita mo, inaangkin mo. Parang ganyan din na sumasakit sa akin, baka meron ng cancer na ganyan, no? Parang naiisip mo, after a while, wala na naman. So, worries, we all worries, and I myself worry. And you know, when was the time we always worried? Pagkatapos ng sweldo. Okay? That's the time we worried. Because, I'm speaking to myself. Because when I get my salary, okay, I think this is not enough to pay all my bills. Okay, so we started to worry. But you know what? What I did, you know, I prayed to the Lord. I give what's belong to God. And Lord, I believe that you will supply the rest. Because you try God. You try God. That's what Malachi says. But it's not on how to get rid of our worries, but also how to respond to our worries. Of course, if you lost your job, you're going to worry. If your child is sick, if you have sickness, or like Father said, if your expenses is more than what you're earning. So worry is one of the devil's greatest weapon to steal our joy and contentment. Ito yung nag-aalis sa atin ng ating joy, and God wants us to be joyful. That's why it says here, God wants us to be joyful, because the joy is coming from our heart. So whatever situation you have in life, you have joy. It's not happiness. Because happiness is dependent on the happenings that's happened to you. If there's no happiness, it means that you are not happy anymore. That's why it is joy. God wants to be joyful on whatever situation we have in life. Now, this statistic shows that when it comes about worry, okay, it says that 40% of the time we worry about things that will never happen. 40% hindi nangyayari yung pinaproblema natin. 30% concern things that cannot be changed. Hindi na natin mababago. Pero we still worried. Why to worry? Anyway, hindi mo na naman mababago eh. Just putting pressure, stress into your life. 12% is centered on criticism, mostly untrue, made by people who feel inferior. Or 10% is related to health, which worsen when you worry. Minsan, iniisip natin, baka may ganito ka, but like what I told you, no? Iniisip mo na you have those sickness. But why worry about those things na wala pa naman? So, enjoy your life. So, worry could be different from different culture. Okay? If you're in African country, you know, you would worry about food. If you are probably in Liberia, you will worry about Ebola and the surrounding places. And if you are in the Philippines for holiday, you would be probably worried what, you know, because they thought that you have money and they're all, you know, going to you and borrows money because you are a Balikbayan and they thought you have many money, so you are worried that they might, you know, manghihiram sa akin ng pera. So, if you live in Ireland, you worry about probably the incoming water bill. Okay? The people talks about that. No? You're probably worried about the additional tax and the additional USC, or and you probably, when November is nearly approaching, December, you are worried about the weather. And it says that this is the coldest year in the last 100 years. Right? Okay. But are you going to worry? Anyway, it's not cold yet, so why to worry? Okay? So the second cause of our worry is the media. The headline, the global news brought into your mind every day. If you are watching Sky News, BBC, and even your Facebook, you can hear something that is frightening. I was told by my friend that there will be a 6 days total darkness, you know, the total eclipse of your heart. No? The total eclipse, 90%, according to NASA. When I look at it, it's not a hoax. It's a hoax. No, hindi katotohanan yon. So imagine people are trying to put, instill worry into your mind. But long time ago, matagal ng panahon, hindi pa tayo pinapanganak, the Bible talks already about worry. And the New Testament was written 40 to 100 AD, and this message is very much applicable in our generation today. So let us open our Bible to the Matthew, book of Matthew 6, 25 to 33. Matthew, masyadong malalaki. Anyway, you're still young, you can still read that. Yeah. When you reach the age of 35 like me, okay, you cannot, you know, read from afar. Okay, so those who are above 35, if you want to read, you can come forward. So you can read it clearly, okay? So if you are, you know, if you are above 35, you should always sit in front, like Ate Leia and Ate Leven, you know? So they always sit in front because they might worry that they might not read my projection, okay? Now, I'm going to read, and I took this from New Living Translation because NLT is easy to understand. Ibig sabihin, madali yung English. Okay, kaya ito po, yung kinuha pang translation. Okay, verse 25. Are you there, guys?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That is why I tell you not to worry about everyday life. Okay? Whether you have enough food or drink, or enough clothes to wear, isn't life more than food, and your body more than clothing? Look at the birds. They don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, but your heavenly Father feeds them. And are you far more valuable to Him than they are? And this is our title. Can all your worries add a single moment to your life? And why worry about clothing? Look at the lilies of the field and how they grow. They don't work or make their clothing. Yet Solomon, in all his glory, was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for wildflowers that are here today and thrown into the fire tomorrow, He will certainly care for you. Why do you have so little faith? So don't worry about these things saying, what will we eat? What will we drink? What will we wear? These things dominate the thoughts of unbelievers, but your heavenly Father already knows all your needs. Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and He will give you everything you need. And I would like to share three things in accordance with these verses that we have read. Number one is contentment is a gift of God. Contentment is a gift of God. Contentment is a gift of God. 25 says, that is why I tell you not to worry for everyday life, whether you have enough food or drink or enough clothing to wear. Isn't it life is more than food and your body is more than clothing? And this verse is not encouraging us. Hindi po natin sinasabi ng verse na to not to plan, not to do any planning for the future. Because when we said, do not worry, okay, that's good. I won't worry anymore. But who will give your food? Okay, so we are not encouraging not to do any planning for the future. That is surely not the case of this verse. Because the Bible mentioned that those who won't care for their relatives, no, especially those in their own household, have denied the true faith. And such people are worse than unbelievers. It means that we have to look after our family. We have to plan for our family, for the education of our children, for a savings for your future, savings for your retirement, okay? Maybe in the next 40 years, okay? So, we have to plan for our future. And these verses doesn't mean that don't worry, you don't need to plan. We really need to plan for our future. And I think most of us, especially Filipinos, you know, even myself, we really don't plan ahead of time, you know, in terms of money or in terms of the education. That's why when nandiyan na, nahihirapan na tayo. But anyway, wala naman talaga tayo, it's the same. Okay, nung nasa Philippines, but it's a different story. But at least you have to plan for the future of your children. But na makikita nyo dito, the connection na ditong verses na to, in the verse 25, bakit sinabi niya dito na don't worry about food? Eh, syempre, you need food, no? For you to survive. You need clothing. But let us see, what is the connection of these verses in the preceding verse? Ito ang sabi, don't store up treasure here on earth, where moths eat them and rust destroys them, and where thieves break in and steal. Store your treasure in heaven, where moths and rust cannot destroy, and thieves do not break in and steal. Wherever your treasure is, there the desires of your heart will be also. So in ancient time, nung pong panahon nila, okay, their treasure are food. Their treasure are clothing. That's why sabi doon, where moth can attack, or eat her clothes. Metal, that's their treasure, the metal, the jewelry, where rust destroys, or thieves breaks in and steal. That is the connection that we can still apply today. We know that physical life is important, but not the final result. So, kung dati po, the treasure is food, they have to store. Yung clothing nila, syempre, wala ka pa namang mabibili na ready-made na for example, na mga branded, okay, you have, kailangan mong tahiin kung ano mang ginagawa nila doon. So, yun po ang kanilang treasure. But, in our generation today, the treasure is different. Di ba? Iba na po ang treasure natin ngayon. Anong treasure natin ngayon? Pwedeng our treasure is yung car natin. Our treasure is our houses. Bili tayo ng bili ng house, walang nakatira. We buy a lot of land, you know, money, savings, no? And then gadget. That's our treasures, okay? So it still applies doon po sa sinabi sa verse 25 that do not store your treasure here on earth kasi mawawala to. Okay? That is the connection of that. But the key thought here is worry. Do not worry. Okay? What are the things that torment yourself from disturbing? That torments yourself from disturbing thoughts. If your happiness depends on the possession, the things, the material things that you have, you could lose it any moment. Ibig po sabihin yung mga material things na to na mawawala, pwede itong mawala in any moment. What if your joy is dependent on those things? They are not lasting. So wherever you put your interest, wherever you put your resources and your energy, that is your priorities in life. But the point here is contentment is knowing God. Yung kilalanin pa natin ang Panginoon sa buhay natin. who is God into our lives. Now, there is a great gain in godliness. There is a great gain in godliness with contentment, for we brought nothing into this world, and we cannot take anything out of this world, but if we have food and clothing, will this be enough? If it's been, be content, contented for what you have. And Job says, you know, in the book of Job says, naked I came from my mother's womb, naked I will depart. Lahat po na kung anumang meron tayo na material things, we cannot bring that in heaven. All the things, why focus on the things? The point is, why focus on the things that will not last forever? Why don't focus on your soul that when you die in this world, you have eternal life? And that is everlasting. Amen? So, this is contentment is a gift of God. And the truth here is God does care for His children. Number two is, okay, human is the most important creation of God. We are the most important creation of God. In verse 26 says, look at the birds. They don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, but you're feeding them? Who's feeding the birds? Our Heavenly Father. Okay? Our Heavenly Father feed them. Father ba nila yon? No. He is our Father. We belong to Jesus. And aren't you far more important or valuable to Him than they are? Hindi ka ba mas importante sa mga ibon na to at sa mga bulaklak na ito na nakikita mo sa iyong paligid? And why worry about clothing? Look at the lilies of the field and how they grow, and they don't work or make their clothing. So, it doesn't mean that we're not going to work. Huh? Because the Bible says that if you don't work, don't eat.
No work, no eat.
So if you live with your family, of course, if you don't have work, you have to do something in your house. Because if you don't work, you're not allowed to eat. Right? No, the Bible says if you don't work, don't eat. So the youth, I'm telling this to the youth, okay, that you have to help your parents. Okay? Even to, no work, no eat. The youth here, that's no work, no eat. You have to help your parents and whatever parents is telling you to do. Not kung inuutusan, biglang nagro-roll eyes. Okay? Pero, tatawag, Mami, ano pang pagkain natin? Diba? So, you have to work. But in this verse, sila yung mabait niya, lagi nagluluto. Okay, the text did not mention a specific name of lilies. And the text did not mention the specific name of the birds. But that's, ganito yan eh. Okay, the setting of this message is Sermon on the Mount. Okay? So, when Jesus is preaching and the people, you know, are just sitting down, eto, parang ganito. Sabi niya, look at the birds. Nakaupo tayo eh. Kasi wala pong ganito, walang microphone, walang projector. People are just going into the, you know, mountain, kung saan man yun. And then they're just sitting down and they're listening to Jesus. And Jesus is standing there. Or probably whatever Jesus is sitting down because they said the teacher before, they are just sitting down, okay? And baliktad, okay? Ako uupo, kayo tatayo. That's the way they preached before, no? And siguro sabi ni Jesus, look at the birds on the sky, okay? They don't plant or harvest, and they don't store on barns. But your Heavenly Fathers feed them. Nakikita nila, actual, with their own eyes, they can see the birds flying on the sky. Look at these birds. Wala silang ginagawa, pero pinapakain sila ng kanyang Ama sa langit. And look at these lilies on the ground. Nakikita mo sila, napakaganda nila eh. Wala namang nagbibihi sa kanila. Hindi sila nagtatahe. Pero look at them. Yun ang kinumpir ni Jesus Christ sa kanila. Kasi yun yung Sermon of the Mount to. So, it is clear in this message that God created the animals. God created the animals. And Jesus, you know, God, Jesus loved the animals, but animals cannot fellowship with God. Okay? Because we are the most important creation of God. Even we are higher than angels. Because that's why God, grace is applied to us. No? The things that we cannot deserve, it's only Jesus Christ died on the cross for human being. Para po sa atin, namatay si Jesus. Kaya po tayo, ang pinaka-importanteng creation ng God. Sa atin nag-a-apply yung love ng Diyos sa buhay, sa atin. No? Kaya He gave His only begotten Son to die on the cross for us to be saved. That one day, we're going to have a fellowship with God. Yun ang sinasabi niya. So why worry so much with the material things that probably you will live in this earth for 80 years? But you focus on worrying about money, about material things, okay, worrying about, pero after 8 years, mawawala na yon. Why don't you focus yourself on the things that will last forever and is your relationship with Jesus Christ? So I'm saying that God loves the animal because even, you know, in the creation of the world, He created the animals and it was Adam who gave them the names of each every animals, but we have the authority over them. But you can see that, you know, today human rights are more well known. You know, I believe that evangelism is more important than animal rights. But the world, the media is siding more on the animal rights than the rights of the unborn children. Then they are fighting more for the animals' rights. They are fighting more for the insects, okay, for the chicken, than fighting for the abortion. And that's what the world is. They are fighting for the non-important things than the important things. Ito po ang sabi niya sa Genesis, "Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a helper suitable for him.' And out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast in the field and every bird on the sky and brought them to the man to see what he would call them, and whatever the man called a living creature, that was its name." So we are, we have the authority over the animals, but we are the highest creation. You are God's greatest masterpiece of creation. We are the greatest masterpiece. Amen. So and lastly, is have faith in God. Yung una, contentment is a gift of God. Pangalawa, human is the highest creation of God. And number three is, and the last, is have faith in God. Jesus also was preaching this because he wants to have his listener to have faith in him. Okay, sabi dito, in the verse 29, "Yet Solomon, in all his glory, was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for wildflowers that are here today and thrown out into the fire tomorrow, he will certainly care for you. Why do you have so little faith?" So it says, we are more important than the flowers and the birds that is flying on the sky. And sabi dito, we are here today and gone tomorrow. Ito sinasabi niya doon sa mga wildflowers, ano? Here today and thrown out into the fire. Okay? It doesn't, hindi po sabihin na pupunta ka sa impyerno. This is not an eschatological judgment. Yung mga judgment, di ba? May nababasa tayo na there will be a fire. This is a different story. No? This is a different context because in the ancient times, okay, yung mga dry grasses or yung mga stem, okay, parang kung pinanganak sa Pilipinas, alam mo nung mga medyo siguro sinagaling ng mga kami yung mga medyo take 5 na kami ngayon eh. So, na-experience pa namin to. Yung, alam mo yung nanguha kayo ng mga kahoy, tapos ano, yung nagluluto kayo sa apoy. Diba? Yan yung pinukuha nila. And thrown out into the fire. Parang ganun ano. Noong mga panahon na they use this to, yung para magluto sila ng ginagamit nila to sa oven, okay, para magluto sila ng mga bread. So, kaya ito, yung mga wildflowers, they are thrown into the fire. Okay, yung mga stem. Kinukuha nila to, and then ginagamit nila na panggatong. Yun, panggatong pala yung table. So this is a metaphor, the transients. The transients of life. Ibig sabihin that things that will not last forever. We are compared also to those lilies on the field that, you know, like them, we don't last forever also. This is also a metaphor, you know, simile, allegory, yung shortness of life na hindi forever ang buhay natin dito sa mundo ito. And kaya na sinasabi niya na our life here on this earth is only short. Okay? And so why focus so much on the things that will not last forever? So I'm not saying that don't care for your body. You have to. Okay? Misa kasi when you say that things, you know, and sometimes it was instilled into our mind that you don't worry anymore. That's why some people doesn't work anymore. You know? But that's not the case. The Bible also says that we're the temple of the Holy Spirit, so you have to look after your body, okay? And but the point here is why spending too much time in worrying? Why spending too much time on the things that is not important? And as what I said, that Jesus is teaching this message because he wants to have his people to have faith in him. For example, there are three incidents that Jesus spoke about why you have so little faith. So in Matthew, sabi niya ganon, the story in the book of Matthew 8:23, sabi niya doon yung why have so little faith. Ito yung the disciples and Jesus, they were on the boat at nagkaroon ng very strong storms, okay? And si Jesus Christ ay nandun din sa boat, but he was sleeping. Natutulog siya dun sa boat, but the disciples were so worried about what's happening because of the strong winds, because of the strong typho na parang mamamatay na sila. But look at that, Jesus is so quiet. He wasn't worried about what is happening outside. Diba? So Jesus, he knows, okay, he was under it, he knows that he doesn't worry about those things because his heavenly Father will look after them. So, eto yon. And kasi we they look on what's happening. Pag ikaw tumitingin ka dun sa background mo, dun sa nasa sa labas mo, you will be worried. It's like they are the one putting worries into our mind. They are the one who instill worries into our mind. And then may isa pang istorya na sinabi niya sa why you have so little faith nung nakita natin si Jesus ba talaga yan? And sabi sa kanya ni Peter, kung si Jesus ka nga, he challenged Jesus Christ, palakarin mo ako sa tubig. And then, Peter walked on the water. Okay? Naglakad siya sa tubig. And then, ang nangyari, nung nakita niya yung strong winds, syempre sa dagat, yun, strong winds and the waves, bigla siya naman. So, anong nakikita niya dito? He saw his problem, okay? Nakikita niya yung problema niya, yung outside background niya nakikita niya because he was not focused on Jesus. And then, kaya nag-worry siya. Bigla siya nag-worry, lumubog siya. Nakita mo yung isang story, the first one that I said, Jesus, you know, even there was a storm, Jesus was quiet, he was just sleeping, and he's not worrying, okay? He's not worrying. Pero ito si Peter, nung naglalakad siya, sabi niya, chinalan sa Jesus, napalakarin niya ako sa tubig, maglakad. And then, he's actually, hindi ko alam kung, hindi sinabi kung ilang step na, no? Pero lumakad siya sa tubig. Okay? That's the point, lumakad siya sa tubig. Pero nakita niya yung strong winds, bigla siya lumubog kasi nakita niya yung problema. Hindi niya nakita si Jesus sa buhay niya. Ganun din tayo. When we look into our problems, lumulubog tayo. Pero kung alam natin na si Jesus, nandiyan siya, we are focused, we don't worry. But if we look on our problems, we worry about so many things. And lastly, the story in the book of Matthew is, why you have so little faith? That yun din na sinabi niya eh. Tatlong beses niya ito sinabi sa book of Matthew na bakit wala kayong pananampalataya. So yung mga tao, yung mga disciples, they're talking about no bread. Okay? And then si Jesus was, sabi nila, bakit, anong pinag-uusapan nyo? Sabi niya, anong pinag-uusapan nyo nung wala tayong bread? Sabihin natin nga, wala tayong mga pagkain. Sabi niya sa kanya, hindi nyo na ba naalala na nagpakain tayo ng 5,000 from 5 loaves? Okay? So parang sinasabi niya, hanggang ngayon pa ba, hindi pa kayo natututo. Ilang beses ko na kayong niligtas. Ito, he was talking to his disciples, you know? He was talking to his students. How many times pinatigil ko yung bagyo? Pinalakad kita sa tubig, okay? Pero, ngayon, ilang beses na tayo nagpakain ng marami? 5,005 loaves. Di ba marami pang natira? Nag-ubi pa nga kayo sa bahay niyo. May mga natira pa. And then, hindi pa kayo natuto that I will provide for your needs if you believe in me. So that's why Jesus was telling this story to them because he wants you to increase your faith. And you know, faith, you have to ask God to help you to have faith in him. There is no problem God doing the miracle. We are the problem because we don't have faith in him. Amen?
Amen.
So, that's the design of that message. And why worry? Life is short, but live your life in the fullness of God. Amen. Amen. So, una po, these three, sabi niya, contentment is a gift from God. We are the highest creation. We are the important creation of God because, Jesus Christ died for us. Sa atin lang siya namatay. Sa atin lang siya nagmahal. Pero, tayo pa yung matitigas sa ulo. Kaya nga may grace po. We don't deserve that. But because of the grace of God, he loves us so much. And lastly, have faith in God. Amen? Let us bow down our heads and pray. Panginoon Diyos, marami pong salamat sa mensahe mo. At Lord, even po 2,000 years ago, sinabi mo na Panginoon sa iyong mga anak na huwag kayong magulumihanan. Don't worry for so many things. Dahil hindi naman po ito, O Diyos, makapagbibigay even a single moment to our lives, O God. Lord, naniniwala po kami na ang contentment po ay nanggagaling sa iyo, O Diyos. But sometimes we are so hard-headed, O God, at hindi po namin alam ang gagawin namin, O Diyos. Kaya, Panginoon, kami po lumalapit sa iyo, O Diyos. Turuan mo kami na magdepende sa iyo, O Lord. Turuan mo kami, Panginoon, na magkaroon pa ng malalim na pananampalataya, Lord. Because the problem is not the miracle that you're going to do in our lives, O God. But our problem is, Lord, lack of faith. Sabi mo, if you have faith like a mustard seed, O God, you can move this mountain. And Lord, I pray that, I pray that you would give us smaller than mustard seed, O God, because I believe that this seed will grow, O God. Ito pong seed na to ay mag-grow sa puso namin, O Lord. And as we fellowship with you, as we depend on you, O Lord, as we read your word, O God, ay magkakaroon po kami, O Diyos, ng pananampalataya sa iyo, Lord. Panginoon Diyos, I pray for every soul that is here, Lord. Panginoon, nangusap pa sa kanila, O Diyos. Dalangin ko, Panginoon Diyos, na ibigay mo ang kanilang pangangailangan. Maybe some of us here, O God, have experiencing worries, O Lord. But Lord, ikaw lamang po ang nakapaalam ng aming mga pangangailangan. Ang sinabi mo, O Diyos, na bago mo pahingin ito, alam mo na, O Diyos. At Lord, dumadalangin po ako that they may know that you are the God who answers our prayer. That you are the God, O Lord, who always take care of us, O God. Panginoon, mag-usap ka sa kanila, O Lord, that when they get out of this place, Panginoon, hindi sila yung katulad ng pumunta sila dito. That their love for you grows and grow, Panginoon. Yung contentment po namin, Panginoon, ay napag-aaralan namin, Panginoon. At yung aming pananampalataya, Panginoon, na every time, Panginoon, na kami ay nakikinig na yung salita, ito po ay nag-increase. Lord, tulungan mo po kami sa aming mga panalangin na ito, O Diyos. At Lord, mangusap ka sa bawat isa, Panginoon. Inasa paglabas po namin sa aming mga trabaho, O Lord, kung may mga worry, Panginoon, ingatan mo kami, O Lord. Let your favor be upon all of us, O God. We thank you, Lord. We bless you. And this is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.